How many? 36 units. Valued at the rate of 5. 180. Exactly what we have done is, we have utilized the abnormal gain to reduce normal loss. That is why on the debit side of abnormal gain you should write 2 normal loss, and on the credit side of the normal loss you should write abnormal gain. How we have to write the same 36 units here? Rate per unit of the normal loss is 5, 36 into 5, 180. Whatever you have written here, same amount should be recorded on the credit side. Now, first of all, among 3 accounts, close abnormal gain account. Now tell me, which side is more? As far as total cost column is concerned, credit side is more. As far as the units are concerned, both the sides equal. So I am closing this account. Afterwards, you can copy. Don't copy now. 36. Units column is closed. Unit cost dash. You are not supposed to find out. Total cost, credit side is more, 1368. Same amount on the debit side, 1368. 1368 minus 180. 1188. Are you sure?
Yes.
Now this 1188 is your gain, net abnormal gain. Now question arises, what to do with this net abnormal gain? So this net abnormal gain of 1188 should be transferred to profit and loss account. In cost accountancy there is a profit and loss account. Like in financial accountancy we have profit and loss account. In cost also we have profit and loss account. We call it as costing profit and loss account. So this net abnormal gain should be transferred to costing profit and loss account. So on the debit side you should write to costing profit and loss account dash 1180. You know this is the net gain. On the debit side of abnormal gain you should write to costing profit and loss account. While preparing costing P&L account, on the credit side we record what? By abnormal gain. On the credit side we record by abnormal gain. Here he is not asking us to prepare costing profit and loss account, but simply you have to write on the debit side as to costing profit and loss account 1188. This account is closed. Next, abnormal loss. How many units are there? 15 units are there. Usually, a realizable value of abnormal loss is given to you in the problem. If it is not given to you in the problem, then the units of abnormal loss are realized based upon the cost per unit of normal loss. I repeat. See, usually the realizable value of abnormal loss is given to you in the problem. But sometimes it may not be given to you. When it is not given to you, then make an assumption that abnormal loss units are realized based upon the cost per unit of normal loss. So in our problem, a realizable value of abnormal loss is not given. So make an assumption that the units of abnormal loss is realized based on the cost per unit of normal loss. Now how to deal with this? You see here, I am selling the abnormal loss units in the market as scrap. So how to write? When the units of abnormal loss are sold, bank account debited to abnormal loss account. On the credit side of the abnormal loss account, I have to write by bank. How many units are there? 15 units. At what rate they are realized? Based on the cost per unit of normal loss. This abnormal loss is in which process? Second process. The cost per unit of the second process is? The cost per unit means what? Cost per unit of the normal loss is 4 rupees here. So assume that units of abnormal loss are realized based on the cost per unit of normal loss. Cost per unit of the normal loss of the second process is 4 rupees. So assume that those 15 units are also realized at the rate of rupees what, sir? 4. Why 4? Because The cost per unit of the normal loss of the second process is 4, and abnormal loss is also in the second process. That is why we have to use this rate, 4 rupees. Now, 50 into 4, 60. 60, sir. 50 into 4, 60. What does it mean? It means that units of abnormal loss were sold based on the cost per unit of what? Normal loss. Now we need to close abnormal loss account. Tell me which side is more?
Debit side.
Debit side is more than credit side. Now we need to close this account. The balance left over in the abnormal loss is to be transferred to costing profit and loss account. So observe the both. As far as the units are concerned, both the sides equal, no change. Dash, dash. If you see the total cost column, debit side is more, 300. Same amount we should record on the credit side, 300. 300 minus 60 is
240.
Net abnormal loss is how much, miss? 240. Actually, abnormal loss is 300 rupees. But we have sold the units of abnormal loss in the market based on the cost per unit of the normal loss, and we are able to recover 60 rupees. As a result, our loss is reduced. From 300 it is reduced to 240. Our loss is reduced by 60 rupees. Why? Because we have sold scrap. By selling the losses as scrap, we got certain realizable value. How much? 60 we got. 300 minus 60, 240 is the net loss. Now question arises, what to do with this net loss? This net loss is to be transferred to costing profit and loss account. Yes or no? So the credit side we should write by costing profit and loss account. That's it, this account is closed. Then normal loss. We need to close the normal loss account. Assume that all the units of the normal loss are realized in the market. It is sold in the market. So we should write on the credit side as by bank. By what? Bank. How to find the amount means? By closing the normal loss account. Look at the whole. Get the debit side total?
271.
Now 271 minus 36?
235.
235. That means 235 units are there. They were sold in the market. By selling them in the market, how much amount is realized? Let's see. Tell me the debit side total.
1,110.
Same amount on the credit side. 1,110.
930.
That means all the units of normal loss were sold at the rate of what's the rupees? 930. Sure. How we got this 930? 1,110 minus 180 is 930. So copy this.